पानी हम लोग इधर से गटर में सब लोग पानी निकालते
हम लोग ने म्यूनसिपैलिटी को कम से कम 7-8 महीने हुआ कम्प्लेंट दिया 100 लोगों का साइन लेके फिर भी म्यूनसिपैलिटी ने कोई इसमें ये नहीं किया सफाई करने का कोई कोशिश नहीं की।
With a population of almost 1.5 crore, the number of people here grows leaps and bounds every day. Yet like all other natural resources, water supply does not increase. A sizable population now has to live on rationed water supplies, often getting water as less as for 1 or 2 hours in a day. Mumbai, an ever-growing, bustling city, has only limited water supplies for its people.
कमाने वाले कोई नहीं हमारे तो पैसा देके पानी भरते
महीने का देते हो या मतलब
महीने का
कितना
200-300
200-300 में आपको कितना पानी मिल जाता है कितने अंडे पानी 6 अंडा
7 अंडा ऐसा पानी मिलता है
और अगर एक दिन पानी नहीं आता है नल में तो आप क्या करते हैं
वो गुजारा करते हैं वो पानी से गुजारा करते हैं
Then there are those people who have a constant supply of water that is simply undrinkable, unusable, and in most cases then unneeded. The water that is provided to them is often so horrible that they'd rather seal their taps off. However, Mumbai, being home to a population with a can-do, will-do, have-to-do attitude, quite a few people make do with what little they have, even if it means the dirtiest waters. Even in ordinary everyday conditions, with polluted water supply, thousands of people suffer every day, not only in terms of health, but also economically.
गटर का पानी हम लोग इधर से गटर में से हम लोग पानी निकालते
हैं। तो पीने का पानी
पीने का पानी वही वो आगे से आता है थोड़ा नल रखा है उसमें थोड़ा पानी मिलता है ना तो हम लोग गटर का पानी से
जिसके बाद नल पे पानी उससे मांगना पड़ता है 2 अंडा 2-3 अंडा 2 करके
200-300 रुपये
एक नल पैसा देकर फिर अपन पानी एक बार कोई गारंटी नहीं कि हमेशा रहेगा तो यहाँ का जो पानी आप लेते हैं वो किसके लिए यूज़ करते हैं
ये अपन कपड़ा धोने बर्तन धोने नहाने यूज़ करते हैं क्या करेंगे पानी नहीं रहेगा तो किधर जाएगा इधर बहुत लंबा है अभी जो हम लोग पैप जो जिस लोग ने लाए ले आए वो लोग भी पैसा लेके पानी देते हैं 200-300 रुपये लेके पानी क्या करेंगे पानी नहीं और इतना गंदगी है नाले में कि कीड़े हो गए मच्छर को मच्छर हो गए मच्छरों को इतना बीमारी हो गया मलेरिया हो गया अभी कितने जन को हो गया कितने बार इधर आके न्यूज वाले लोग देखते हो करते पर कुछ भी नहीं करते अभी मेरा छोकरा को भी
अभी फिर 3 दिन से बुखार है बिल्कुल साइन में आगे फिर मलेरिया निकल
There are a number of regular practices that need to be looked into, well, regularly. Almost all, if not all, of the industrial waste ends up in our water bodies, since strict action is not taken about their safe disposal. Take Sivri's Sitagarh area for instance. It has a whole stretch of road covered with sludge and dirty water, a result of water mismanagement from the surrounding areas. In this way, day after day, industries contaminate our groundwater systems. के लिए जो प्रॉब्लम है ये कितने टाइम से है?
6 साल से आसपास, 6 साल हुआ कम से कम।
ठीक है, और ये पानी सब कहाँ से आता है?
पानी सर्विस सेंटर से आता है, वो उधर 16 शौचालय उधर से आता है, ये लोगों से जहाँ के बाथरूम नहीं उधर से आता है, मतलब नाली नहीं है, नाली बनाने पोटर्स ने, तो वहाँ से आता है सब लोग का पानी, तीनों तरफ से पानी आता है, इसलिए रोड खचा भरे रहा है पूरा।
ठीक है, कोई साफ किया ये रास्ता?
कोई साफ किया नहीं, अब जब हम लोगों ने म्यूनसिपैलिटी को कम से कम 7-8 महीने हुआ कंप्लेंट दिया, 100 लोगों का साइन लेके फिर भी म्यूनसिपैलिटी ने कोई उसमें ये नहीं किया, सफाई करने का कोई कोशिश नहीं की।
ठीक है, तो आपको क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम होता है इसकी वजह से?
मलेरिया, बुखार आता है, बीमार पड़ता है, ये सब चालू है हमें के लिए।
E-waste is nothing but all electronic as well as electrical waste which are discarded along with its ancillary components, the spare parts as we say. So all together make up our e-waste. Having said that, we know which are the major ones, could be maybe your CRTs, the cathode ray tubes, maybe your circuit boards, switches, your battery cells, name them. So all this forms your e-waste. Having understood this, we need to know, now we can go back to see what is it that really pollutes the water. Now the chemicals that make up these components is what is hazardous to the environment. Now talking about the chemicals, again there are many, for that matter the cell phone that you may have with you right now could be having close to 200 chemical compounds in it. So just imagine the amount of chemicals that go as e-waste with every product that you use. So that's the kind of pollution that we're talking about with e-waste. Now, to name a few chemicals, we can talk about mercury, we can talk about lead, sulfur, then BFRs. BFRs are nothing but the brominated fire retardants that are majorly used in electronic and electrical products so that they don't catch fire. Then there is cadmium, there is palladium, there are number of chemicals. Now, all these chemicals end up somehow into either the air, soil or the water and cause the pollution. How do they reach these water bodies is something we need to look at. Now, as we all know, countries like India, China, Malaysia, we are huge dumping grounds for the US and the UK. We are huge dumping ground for e-waste. Now, with so much e-waste plus the indigenous e-waste that is produced every day, it is not really possible or feasible to really recycle all this e-waste at that pace. So most often than not, it is either directly put into the water bodies or it is filled into the landfill. And this is where the major problem begins. Without having treated or diluted the effects of these chemicals, it is dumped into the ground. And that is where the leaching of this chemical slowly gets into the soil and into the water bodies, all the chemicals. And most of these chemicals are hazardous, are toxic. Barring a few, most of them are toxic. So this is how these chemicals finally find their way into the water bodies.
A large part of the population also causes water bodies to be constantly polluted. Water that could otherwise be fit for human consumption and use is constantly being spoiled. A large number of people living near water bodies are known to throw their garbage directly into water bodies in their surroundings, causing almost irreversible clogging, and hence are ultimately breeding disease and sickness for themselves. While the problem of garbage disposal here is massive in itself, it also has effects on the water systems of the city.
What are some of the effects of water pollution on mangroves? Okay. In fact, you may be aware that mangroves are intertidal ecosystem or coastal ecosystem, which are generally found nearby seashore, and they help us to reduce water pollution by absorbing suspended particulate matter in water and also heavy metals. But when it goes beyond carrying capacity of any ecosystem, it starts getting affected by water pollution. You must be aware that many industries in Mumbai and in other parts of India, they release their effluents without treating. And mangroves are very susceptible to water pollution, especially when it is pesticide or herbicide. And you also might have heard about oil spills. So they are very susceptible to oil spills because this oil, they block the stomatas or the leaves and pores or lenticels on stem and root. And the transport of gases or oxygen stops. So they start dying and they get affected due to water pollution.
Water wastage is something that we are all culprits of. It's not like we do it on purpose, but our habits have evolved negatively to such dangerous levels that we don't even realize that we are wasting anymore. When we use a shower instead of a bucket bath, we use 4 times as much water as we would with a bucket bath. Washing of vessels unintelligently also wastes liters of water every day. Every tap left open reduces our water supply, each drop eventually forming an ocean of wastage. Even school activities like watering the ground excessively leads to enormous wastage. Water pipes left unattended will one day bleed this city dry of its water supply.
We're already seeing the effects of bad water management in Mumbai. We're not getting clean water where it's required. Just a couple of days back, we had sections of Mumbai complaining that they were receiving yellow-tinged water in their taps. So now that is an example of how something has gone wrong with the management of water. And so it's an everyday scenario. I mean, if you want to predict what will happen maybe a month down the line, next year at this time, that kind of a thing in a couple of years, we all know it doesn't look good at all. Every year we're waiting for the monsoons, and if we don't get enough rain, we're thinking what's going to happen through summer. We'll run out of water, our lakes will fall below their drawable levels. What do we do then? If you're using water, use it wisely. Use it with caution. It is something that is going to run out. So I'm positive we can make a difference, just you and I, better managing our water. We'll have enough to go around.